In our last tale, Rex Lapis.
There you are!
Oh. Here for a few tales. I didn't know you two were connoisseurs.
Oh, no, we're here for you!
Something I'm rarely short of.
We need someone who understands
Zhong. Someone who would...
Take a look around. Is there anyone the requester claims to have enlisted to Van's number one rock expert?
You appear to have taken his claim quite personally on my behalf.
Oh, no. It's just... Uncle Dai doesn't know what he's talking about. I would just want...
I see. Well, then...
Really?
But I should inform you that despite we are at all times adrift in the sea of learning, new knowledge should be welcomed with open arms. Still, I imagine I will be of help to you in this endeavor, if we do.
Stop being so modest, Zhongli!
Must be the friend you spoke of.
Yep, my wife doesn't know
fully. Let's not get ahead of ourselves.
So you say. What am I got here? None will see. It's no use me singing his praises. You'll have to see for yourselves.
Is this the place?
Aha! Speak of the devil. Oh, young Kun, these are two adventurers.
Hmm?
Wangsheng Funeral Parlor's consultant. Mr. Zhongli, I've heard about you. They say you're a man of great knowledge and many talents.
I'm sure I recognize you. Have we met at the parlor?
Uncle Dai, aren't you going to test them?
Huh?
Then we can figure out a way to...
A contest?
I admire your...
I must say, you certainly have the look of an industry expert about it.
Stop talking the talk and start walking the walk!
I'm just saying it like I see it. Which...
So you're an appraiser, Mr. Kunju?
Well, no. Actually, I've already forgotten what I'm in Liyue Harbor for. I was standing by the side of the road one day when Uncle Dai called me over. He saw me holding a rock and asked me a few questions. He seemed incredibly excited, even followed me for a while. We arranged to...
Huh? How could you forget something like this?
I saw him on my way over to Liyue Harbor, pouring over rocks and muttering to himself. He looked to be very familiar with them. I asked him a few questions.
Not exactly. Anyway, if it's rocks you need help with, I can most certainly lend a hand. Mr. Zhongli, what do you make of this rock?
A glossy exterior, and a fissure that could only have been left in the wake of a volcanic eruption. If I'm not mistaken, this is a rough gem.
Ah, a keen eye!
It's no ordinary rough gem. Fragile surface layer, black veining.
Remarkable! This rock does indeed hail from the vicinity of a volcano. I came across it in a market and snapped it straight up. The seller thought it was some leftover industrial remnant. They had no inkling of the treasure that lay within. Purity and geological rarity alone aren't enough to make a treasure. Some of the most precious crystals contain deposits of waters. In the moment of its formation, the crystal hidden in this stone shell captured a pocket of water. For water to be hidden in its depths, like a moon concealed within a mountain, reflecting shafts of daylight that make it through. Now that's a rare treasure.
Such a detailed description. Almost like he saw it with his own two eyes. Say, you're not trying to hoodwink us, are you?
Everything he said is true. Most crystals are born in high-temperature environments. Heat and water aren't natural bedfellows, of course, which is why crystals with water deposits are so sought after. Moreover, this particular crystal contains mountain lake water. A rare find indeed.
Well, if Zhongli said so, it must be true.
I've yet to encounter anyone with a judgment as shrewd as yours, Mr. Zhongli. How did you know exactly what lay within?
I've seen many such stones in my time. I recognized it immediately. I hope you didn't mind me flaunting my experience, Mr. Kunjun.
Of course not! I feel I've met a kindred spirit here today. I hope you will accept my friendship. Uncle Dai, it would be a mistake for Mr. Zhongli not to join us. Trust me when I say that his level of expertise is unrivaled in the trade. You won't come across another of his caliber in your lifetime.
Very well. There is strength in numbers, after all. Everyone, follow me to the chasm. There are men counting on you to find them.
Getting it super fast with GoPop. Download now and order in seconds for delivery in minutes. All for a flat fee of $1.95. GoPop, make now good.
Introducing Butt Dial, a new podcast that eavesdrops on calls between your favorite artists. Like I am.
I don't even know if I should say this.
Dave One from Chromium and Ezra from Vampire Weekend.
I actually think that the sound of the dawn of time exists.
Yeah, it's a shakuhachi. It's a Japanese bamboo flute.
Can you not hear Dave and
Dua? Do you play games at all?
I don't play games, baby.
Butt Dial.
Weird vibes for urgent times.
Tap now to listen for free on Spotify. Useless!
This is where the incident occurred. 6 days ago, I led a team around the entire mine and found no trace.
So four miners have disappeared.
Yes, there were 10 of us. We lost Long, Bold Sen, Brave Sen, and Mao. I worked with all of them.
Workers in this trade are usually young men in the prime of their lives. Could it be that the four of them left for another mine?
Unlikely. There's no other lodging for miles around. We didn't pass any other mines on the way over.
Huh. Such a huge mine. Did you really manage to explore every corner?
Underground, overground. We left no stone unturned. We tried everything short of digging further into the earth itself. But four sturdy young men just vanish into the bedrock.
We'll need to explore the site ourselves before extracting any conclusions.
Very well. I'll wait here. Please, proceed wherever you'd like. If you come across any clues, let me know straight away.
So strange! How could the four of them just suddenly disappear? Did they run away from something? Let's look around first!
four of them have been gone for 6 days without...
There's also a few handkerchiefs.
Items for washing one's face before the dawn shift.
So...
Correct. Improbable, there are four pickaxes missing. It's they had time to take their tools, but not their everyday items? One, they were working close by and didn't need to move their personal effects. But seeing as they've yet to return, this seems an unlikely hypothesis. Or two, they were forced to leave and had no time to think about their supplies. It's certainly a possibility. We'll need more.
If they didn't leave.
Oh, right on time.
Did you find anything?
There's a chunk of ore?
Or, what does it have to do with the disappearance?
Let's find out. I'll give it a try.
The child? What's a child?
I'm not...
Also...
Oh, I don't mean see in the traditional sense. I would appreciate it if what I'm about to tell you remained a secret. It's a... I can perceive the memories of war.
Huh?
Perceive?
You mean you can put your hand...
I've always sensed that ore contains memories. Sometimes it records events that occur in the surrounding area.
Amazing! So you...
It depends on the ore. Some ores have astounding memories. Others, like iron ore and white iron ore, core lapis and crystal memories are much stronger.
Stones.
I'm glad I... Based on what I saw...
This will take us north. Excuse me, sir.
Yes. I don't... I stayed behind you. I ended up falling asleep in the shelter inside. When I woke, maybe...
So the men that were out working disappeared. Perhaps an...
Oh, what a scary on-site accident. We... Found some clues. Time to report back to Uncle Di.
You're back. How are...
We found three... First, there are four missed...
Forced to?
Who indeed. Second, there were five workers at the mine. One of them left the site to take respite. Those who kept working all disappeared. The one who left early emerged safe and sound.
Now that you mention it, I recall... Could someone have entered the site?
This leads me to my third point. Mr. Kun Jun here made good use of his, expert techniques.
A child? But there are no settlements here for miles around.
Unlikely as it sounds, that's our king.
Where did they go?
We believe that they followed the road north.
North? Right. I'll rally my men and head in pursuit. You've been in...
Not so fast. The incident occurred 6 days...
You're right. There are only a few settlements around here, but in the meantime, you could...
Agreed.
All right. Me and my...
Correct.
But there aren't any more clues at the mine.
Wait.
Huh? Oh, yeah! Where's Kunjun?
Hmm.
apologies. I'm conducting a quick search for my own benefit.
Dragonfall. Dragonfall is often used in forging.
I'm sorry. I don't recall why I'm seeking it. I've been feeling very... In fact, I've been feeling extremely anxious. Is it...
Oh, Paimon knows that feeling. When you know you've...
I don't even know where to start with it. I've been... It sounded so familiar to me. As if whatever it was I had to do... Perhaps if I can retrieve some...
I see. If I am able to during a...
Really?
Think nothing of it.
Shouldn't we get going?
Heading north from the chasm, we'll reach Linju Pass. If this is indeed the path they...
Great! Let's have a look!
Let us make our way to the end. They made their way through Lingju.
If we follow their foot... Oh no! The footprints end here!
We should inquire with anyone nearby. If the miners came through here, they may well have seen them.
Stop bothering me.
This is the sound.
Jeez,
of all the
whatever.
And this is the sound of getting it super fast with GoPop. Download now and order in seconds for delivery in minutes, all for a flat fee of $1.95. GoPop, make
there.
Now.
A minor.
When it comes to starting your morning off right, Wendy's is always the best choice. And now that our sweet and savory honey butter chicken biscuit is only $1.99, you have no excuse to get your breakfast anywhere else. It's freshly prepared with sweet honey butter and all white meat chicken on a flaky biscuit. It's never been easier to steer clear.
Hey there!
Breakfast.
It must have been about...
Choose yeah, that's them!
And get the breakfast you
four
deserve.
Or five days.
It was so strange. Four big guys with lifeless expressions. It was like they were in some sort of trance. And there was a child staggering in front of them.
Huh. This child. Did you see what they look like?
I caught a glimpse. Blue hair. Short. I think it was a girl. She wasn't...
And they...
Yes. They both...
Let's go after...
Even up to the night, there!
Help! Please save me!
Is that one of the people we're looking for? Oh, rescue first! Ask questions later!
No rest for the wicked.
Time for retribution!
Teamwork is strength!
Monsters, my name is Wanyu.
Huh?
A miner?
Yeah, we're looking for a group. Really?
Yes. I set off from Nantianmen the day before yesterday, heading for Lingju Pass. I was in a hurry.
I think that's all we needed.
I hope it's useful. I'd better get going. There's a couple.
Can we be absolutely sure that it...
A child with a group of adults. Sounds pretty...
Hey, perhaps that rock over there can tell us more.
Uh-huh.
It looks promising. I'll do my best.
Mr. Kunjun, you're...
I suppose it is an asset, though I rarely find a use for it. But praise for Mr. Zhongli is high...
It's a good thing we brought our Kunjun compass along!
It feels like we're cracking a criminal case.
Be that as it may,
you're quite...
That's not all. We have encountered many clues along the way.
Great!
I left a mark in the...
There's a basket lying here, too.
Hey!
Judging by his appearance...
Should we wake...
I can...
Sounds like he's whispering something!
It seems that he thinks he's... There's a camp nearby. We should take it... himself into a stupor. Thankfully, he's not in serious danger.
Hyman heard him talking about digging for something. Did he dig him?
It's certainly a possibility.
Hmm? It looks like there's something... Are these... War frag...
Hmm.
I just witnessed the memories within these ore fragments. This person brought these fragments out of the mine. He's one of the four that we're searching for.
How he came to be here is what we need to understand.
So he was kidnapped, and then abandoned here. But if they didn't need him, why bring him all the way out here?
Unless something happened. Something that led him to fall behind.
Paimon's had enough! This is too mysterious!
Oh, wait a moment! Seeing these fragments has jogged my memory. I have something for you.
What is it? Ooh, is it a present?
Something for us?
As I mentioned, before I met Uncle Dai, I was in a daze. After setting out with you on this case, it feels like a fog is lifting. I was so happy when Uncle Dai enlisted you to help. I would never have managed to track down these clues by myself. These are some crystals that I bought from the market. Not any old crystals, mind you. This purity is extraordinarily rare. One for each of you. A memory, if you will.
It's beautiful. Oh, and the colors change as you turn it. It's like a different crystal from each angle.
But of course, take... And this one is for Mr. Zhongli.
On the contrary, I just had... But thank you.
I'm pleased you like them. It's nice to be able to give a gift that others can appreciate. Oh, I see more rocks over there.
You sure look...
Ores are the crystals of the earth. The sediment of time itself. I feel... Get some rest and call me when you're ready to set off. I won't be far.
Rest easy. I surveyed the area. There's no danger here. Oh, however, there is something I wanted...
What's with the seriousness of...
Traveler.
You mean the ore that Kunjun...
Dragonfall is an incredibly rare ore used in forging. The majority of regular crystals are formed in high-temperature environments. Dragon...
Elemental reactions can produce material...
Indeed, they can. However, only a... Dragonfall first emerged in the midst of a great battle, thousands of years ago. Powerful clashes of elemental energy gave birth to elemental crystals. When the fighting ceased, these geological remnants were... And yet they are crystal creations all the same. Few and far between, relatively unknown. A few hundred years ago, they were virtual... Why is it then that a citizen of Liyue now wishes to strike upon ore that has long since vanished from... There are those in the mining trade who retain a keen interest in Dragonfall. But for someone like Mr. Kunjun, whose motive...
Ulterior motive?
A conclusion that is presently impossible to reach. We must walk... Don't forget, rescuing those miners is the primary objective. We're drawing closer to our goal. When you're well rested, we should ensure this mine...
No problem. I'm done here.
Any results?
There are many beautiful rocks here, but nothing out of the ordinary. Then again, the memories of ore can shift with the passage of time and the changing of you. Difficult.
So there's never any...
Rocks endure, but as eons pass, their memories are erased.
That makes sense. It is the same...
Indeed.
Let's conduct separate investigations. I'll take that area. Perhaps you could survey this section. All right, then.
Kunjun, can you see anything worth...
Well, there is this stone tablet...
That doesn't seem very interesting.
It's worth a try, surely. Let me see. Oh,
This is...
Hey, what's wrong?
Just a bit lightheaded. It's past. Nothing to worry about. Not...
Whatever. Hyman's going to investigate over there. Why don't you climb the tree? If you don't try, you won't know. Anyway... There's more music
on Spotify. Oh.
When has Hyman ever come... Wait a minute. Hyman can fly.
All of you, come here.
Shelly's... Quick, let's go... ...from Gimlet and the Wall Street Journal. Or dive into the lowly Chippendales phenomenon and its surprising history of drugs, corruption, and murder. And welcome to your fantasy. Whether you've got 5 minutes or an hour, discover original and exclusive podcasts free on Spotify.
This has been newly dug. It would appear our answer...
Is that a voice coming from the tunnel?
Compose yourselves. There is an unusual presence emanating from it. That this whole tunnel is the fruit of their strenuous labor.
Huh? That gate! Has it been here all along?
Digging a tunnel to this ancient seal. Had they not been discovered, they would undoubtedly persevere to the gate.
If you recall, Ishtar, this is not how we intended for events to transpire.
Waste not your words. Your life is mine.
No rest for the wicked.
The Imperator's will not absolve you.
Worthless.
This one's not enough. You would forsake me again?
If that is what you choose to believe, so be it. He who bears the weight of memory is destined to shoulder the burden of truth, as it ought to be.
Watch out!
Allow me.
You've recovered. How can that...
Focus your efforts, Mo... Years after you sealed me underground,
you should call it by its name, Ashtaha. Fate.
So here lies the wisdom of the gods. Destroy all deemed redundant. Enlist tyrants to ravage the wilderness.
No, you have forgotten.
That voice.
Ashtaha.
Huh? Kunjun?
Morax, it's been a while.
You're
Ashtaha. The very same. During the battle, you imbued us with your power.
Yes, it was all I could manage. Forgive me for concealing the truth, traveler. Allow me to elaborate. I am not it. Heaven and earth, yin and yang, opposing forces. You can consider the existence of me and the Ashtaha you see there to be a reflection of such polarities. We are a schism of the will. The will of Ashtaha.
So there are two Ashtahas?
No, it can't be.
When the seal loosened, your power manifested in this world as a child. With this new identity, you were able to vent about the forces that suppressed you. That's when it occurred to you. The loosening of the seal constituted an opportunity to strike back. Kidnapping the miners was all in aid of digging to the entrance to the seal itself. Your plan was to launch an attack on both ends, from outside and within.
The audacity! Are you insane? If you truly are—
I was another power awakened with the loosening of the seal. Too weak to reincarnate, I was barely conscious. I couldn't remember who I was. Only the past would elicit a reaction from me. But my aim was clear.
I had sensed that something was amiss when you mentioned Dragonfall. Had your power been but a little stronger, I would have
Don't blame yourself. I have changed beyond all recognition. Only when I touched the stone tablet did I... It's been so long. A secret beyond all comprehension of youthful humanity and ancient.
There would be no harm in it.
You haven't changed. Then allow me. Ashtaha was once a friend and ally of the Geo-Archon Morax, with a lifespan far exceeding that of mankind. However, that which is derived of the Earth is no more, or the memories of rocks do not last long.
Those memories that survive are rooted in powerful emotion. But as time passes, so these memories fade into obscurity. Erosion is the world's greatest destroyer of memories. Erosion ground Ejdha's consciousness into oblivion. Slowly, he forgot the face of his old friend. Ejdha, now incomplete, became irascible, aggressive.
What would you expect? It was humanity that attacked the ley lines that sustained me!
This much is true. Which is why you attacked the chasm. Why you waged war against Morax. In the beginning, in order to open up new territory and increase production, the citizens of Liyue came to the mountains to mine. Overexploitation caused the ley lines to quake, which brought untold suffering to us. Erosion made us even more savage. No matter how we struggled, we lost the ability to coexist. Morax shared with us some of his power to prevent further erosion. But it was futile. Everything returns to dust. It is the natural order. And so, we became you. And from your will, I emerge. I am your final contract. Witness the promise between Ejdha and Morax. You can hate me, but you cannot deny me.
No!
I am the remnants of Ejdha's benevolence, the echo of a contract set in stone. I harbor...
No, no! It is I, Ejdha, forged of elemental crystal, bearer of the weight and memories of the Earth, older than the mountains and the oceans that decides. I will not...
Morax is not an insect.
A lord over insects is nothing but an insect in...
You forgot yourself. Nobody held Morax in higher regard than you. That which you have forgotten, I hold here in my heart. If you are the memory of the Earth, then I am the memory of coexistence. All powers under heaven, rise and fall of land and sea.
A star appears within the wild. A sun ascends as bright as... jade. Strange.
You are spent. And I'm in the wilderness. Snow falls on a spring day. In an instant, it will melt. Even where it is fleeting and leaves no trace. Even where it will...
No! That isn't true! I don't ex...
Perhaps it isn't. But it...
Morax!
The little girl vanished!
Are you satisfied?
I had to make amends. So, Morax.
I do.
Well, I'm afraid old habits die hard.
As you please.
I never did forget.
I hardly lifted a finger. Think nothing of it.
And yet, you could see. You wouldn't know the yearning of a blind dragon searching for the sun. A pair of eyes from Morax to Ejdha. This. I will remember this.
Your power is nearly spent. Shall we get going, you and...
Surely the pressing matters.
Indeed. Hence the need to get going. To fix the damage left in your...
How did we get here? We need to go back and check on the miners!
So there you are. My men and I found your clues and followed them straight here. We found Mao in a tent at the campsite unconscious. Huh?
Nothing. Pay it no mind.
Cave?
They're exhausted, but not in...
Right. Well, thank you.
So you're taking them back to Liyue Harbor?
That's right.
Can I come with you?
No problem. You rescued my men. I'll be happy to assist all of you in any way.
Kunjun, we should be calling you Ezdaha. You're coming back to Liyue Harbor too, right?
Not I. Once I'm gone, the true owner will accompany the miners back to Liyue. Kunjun hails from a family of famous artisans. He too will be famous in time. It would be a shame.
You always did have a great admiration.
Curious how swords and daggers are blind, yet their creator sees so much. Perhaps empathy is mankind's proudest achievement after all.
Ezdaha, I am no longer...
I can sense it.
Today I am just an ordinary citizen.
Even you met such a fate.
No matter. If that day comes to pass, Liyue must prepare itself to think.
And how will Liyue fare without Rex Lapis?
Even without a god above, this remains a nation of men. I was once their god. I ought to be here to witness their rise and fall.
All life is shaped and then ground away by the endless flow of time. You were always the strongest among us. That's unimportant. Fate is ordained by... You may live forever, doomed to a lonely existence. Yet, even this is temporary. When you reach the end of time, those people, those past and future relationships...
I do not pretend to match your rhetoric when it comes to the subject of a life long lived. I fear that the life of an elemental being is longer than any in this world.
Were it not so, you would have killed me long ago.
You've brought a smile to my face. When all is said and done, a reunion...
That day in the chasm... Did you hesitate?
A heart of stone is a heart nonetheless. But I am the god of contracts, and was for a time a god of the people.
You chose justice, but did not forsake your kindness. You came to me not as an assassin, and so I was willingly...
The movements of the Earth Dragon can tremble the Earth and shake the heavens. With your abilities...
Hence, my... Do not forget that I was there with Liyue's founder. The face may have changed, but the content of the contract remains old friend. God...
Thank you, Ezdaha.
My life is at an end. I will join...
You're leaving?
If it is fated, Morax, we will meet again.
Yes, don't be alarmed. In fact, we have yet to meet the... He was. Centuries may have passed since then, but events from a thousand...
In our last tale, Rex Lapis was walking alone in the mountains. He heard a remote voice, unlike any other, coming from a crack in the earth.
Most of the ancient geo life forms that live below Liyue are blind, having not seen the sunlight for an age.
The voice was sometimes sad and song-like. Other times it was loud and thunderous. The Lord of Geo searched here and there before finally unearthing a strange stone from the bedrock.
That's how Ezdaha was. I answered his wish and took him above ground.
The Lord of Geo took pity on the rock spirit and carved it into a magnificent work of craftsmanship, a vivid representation of a dragon.
I bestowed him with a pair of eyes to see the world, and came to an agreement with him.
With his fingers, he made two eyes. Quicker than words could tell, lightning flashed and thunder roared, and a living, breathing dragon soared into the clouds!
I agreed to let him live among the people above ground. But if the day ever came when he brought ruin to order, he would once again be sealed in the dark.
The dragon accompanied the Lord of Geo, fighting campaigns alongside him in the four corners of the world. We have a saying to eulogize these events. The crash of a spear brought billowing dust. The mountains and waters made way at the sound. The sight of a dragon bestowed with a touch the promise of rainwater blessing the ground.
A thousand years ago, Ajdaha attacked the chasm. I tried to obstruct him, fighting him tooth and nail down the length and breadth of the mine. Finally, I brought him down and sealed him underground. During that battle, Dragonfall was born. Ajdaha could sense the stone. Subconsciously, he wanted to use it to find me. Despite being the victor, I could not claim to be stronger than he. And in his heart, he still retained an ounce of goodwill towards me, towards Leo, towards life above ground. He was willing to be sealed away, but as the erosion set in, he forgot. Even I cannot avoid it, but there is something I understand better than most. When the door opens, the greater the power, the greater the danger erosion may bring about. The millennia may come and go, but even a stone may tire. Personally sealing away an old friend. People abandon and surrender the things they love to pursue the right path. Perhaps this is the erosion imposed on me by the natural order of this world. But I was a god of mankind. My identity may change, but my eyes will...
You still care a lot...
Call it... I must thank you, but...
No worries!
Oh? About what?
Oh, yeah! So, not long ago, we met a guy called Dane. He told us about Conria and the punishment of the gods. That's when we realized that those events... We're connected to the person we're searching for. Zhong Li, you're a god. You've lived through thousands of years of history.
I cannot say.
Why? You can't even give us a thread of information? This is so important to us.
I understand. But I must apologize. This is my contract.
You mean... Another past grievance? Like the incident with Ajdaha?
It was signed before it all began. I have always honored the contract.
How can you be like that?
You two are friends to me. I can assure it brings me no pleasure to disappoint you. But as the god of contracts, I cannot go back on...
Would you be ready to find out?
It appears your understanding of this world continues. There are many events of ages past. Many see they have been eroded by time, forgotten by the people, abandoned. But you are capable of finding them and bringing them into the light. Those who come to witness will witness. Those who are born to remember will. If you take the same road as that person, there may be more difficulties ahead. But as long as you firmly believe that you are on the right path, everything has meaning.